They aren't your typical army going into battle, but their war is just as important. More than 2,000 volunteers are banded together since Hurricane Irma in 2017 to keep the Florida Keys clean.
Brian Vest is the president and founder of the Conch Republic Marine Army. He joins us now live via Skype from Big Pine Key. Brian, thanks so much for joining us. So how did you get the idea to put together this army?
Well, good morning. It's a response to the hurricane basically pushing a couple of thousand homes into the ocean, and the storm surge just washed everything out from all the houses. And it winds up being trapped in the mangroves, which is very difficult to get to. There aren't machines or barges you can use. So we got a couple of friends together to clean up one little stretch, pulled out some sofas, some mattresses, and some refrigerators, and didn't get the job done that day. So we decided to get back together again. And the second time we got together, about 150 people joined us. We did another day. And then on the third time, we had 250 join us. And at that point, we knew we had something pretty special that people of the Keys really do care about, the mangroves and the environment. And it's pretty much destroyed. And so we haven't stopped since then to, like you say, over 2,700 volunteers, now 136 tons of household garbage pulled out of the mangrove.
Wow.
So, yeah, Brian, first of all, congratulations on that. I think it's a wonderful thing that you've done that and started a movement, if you will, down there. But what's the rule? Is this something that FEMA will come back and help you do? Do they have a certain time limit on when they're going to help? Is this stuff that wasn't going to get touched? It would just sit on the sides of roads or in the mangroves?
Well, the stuff on land obviously can be dealt with, you know, fairly easily. You know, neighborhoods and cleanup groups can tackle things like beach cleanups and road cleanups. But the stuff in the water that gets trapped, or what I call global ocean pollution that's just drifting around, there isn't a government agency, a state agency, or a county agency, or a budget to get after this stuff. The only way you can do it is to basically clean up your backyard. And unfortunately for us, our backyard is the entire ocean, 120 miles out in the middle. It's just a monumental task. We've only done 10 linear shoreline miles of over 1,000 to do.
What about all the boats?
This is like,
I mean, there were a lot of boats that, you know, during Irma, you know, sunk debris. What's happening to them? Are you able to pull them out? And then what happens to them next?
There is funding through the FWC to pull what we call derelict vessels out. So they get barges and cranes and take them out carefully. There was about 3,000 boats, I think, that were sunk into the waters. And of course, that's diesel and gas cans that come out. But what people are missing is that, you know, when a house gets destroyed in a flood or a hurricane, everyone looks at the house and says it's gone. Well, it's not gone. It's still there. It's just broken into a million pieces, and it's out in the shorelines and out in the back country. And so is everything that was underneath your kitchen sink. You know, your Ajax, your WD-40, your spray paint cans, your laundry detergent, insecticide. And those things are ticking time bombs as the sun makes the plastic brittle. Bottle bursts open and spills that contents. It kills habitat. Spray paint cans rust and eventually start to drip. In our group, 78 refrigerators out there in the mangroves. And those things are filled with compressors and oil and foam inside the doors. So this is a natural disaster that is really hard to see if you don't get out there into the backcountry, because you don't see it from the main highway. We've got most of that pretty cleaned up. Backcountry is in deep trouble.
Hey, Brian, we only got about 20 seconds left, but I want to ask you, you mentioned only 10 of 1,000 miles that you got to cover here. You expecting your group to get a lot bigger or what in time?
We are hoping for funding or help from the United States somewhere to join us with either dollars or manpower and come down here and help us tackle this just catastrophic challenge. It's just going to take us a decade.
For sure. And then, of course, you worry about another hurricane. Brian
we
Vest.
Do.
Yeah,
correct.
Brian Vest, thank you
Thanks,
so much
Brian.
For your efforts and
Keep up
you
the
know,
good work,
raising
buddy.
This.